Hi everyone, how's it going? It's been 1 week now since the start of the Feudal Japan Challenge here at ArtStation, and looking through the submissions, already a great amount of things are happening. For my own project, I gave myself the extra challenge this year to not only post pictures, but also make little videos along the way. Please bear with me if the sound quality is not like amazing from the get-go, because honestly speaking, when it comes to video production, I don't really have that much experience so far. However, I try to get better at it from video to video to produce better content down the line. So without much further ado, let's jump right into it. This week was probably quite similar for most people, as it was all about taking the vision we started with a week ago, and now individually looking into how can I boil this down into a grey box to really understand what am I going for in terms of staging, but also in terms of scope, in the sense of is it actually achievable. This was something I tinkered with quite a bit past week, as I knew I wanted to make something a little bit bigger, not too big though, but also don't compromise on the vision and story I wanted to tell with the environment. So I settled with a terrain size that sits roughly at 1 square kilometer, and in terms of detail, roughly aim at something along the lines of a total war game or a strategy game in general. Looking at the scene right now, there's certainly a lot more that could be done. However, with the deadline in mind, I will probably leave it as it is for now and worry about the details later. And even if I should decide down the line that I have to do major changes to the terrain, I set up a pipeline that allows me to make those changes relatively painless. To achieve this, I settled with World Creator to sculpt essentially all of my terrain, and then when it comes to exporting or setting up different texture overlays, I'm using either Samsung's Designer where everything is prepared and linked and I just have to rebake, or World Machine to make sure that my output size always fits the terrain that I'm using. The last question I still had to find an answer for was how to pull off the earth cracks leading towards the gatehouse that were so essential to the story. To try something different, I got inspired by Dylan Cole, who was using drywall compound and its tendency to create very, very interesting, especially like cracked looking shapes, and taking pictures from them to use them in his illustrations. I will attempt to do something similar, however, instead of taking just a couple of stills, I will try to use photogrammetry to take this real world data and bake it into 3D geometry. So what you can currently see happening in the video is actually something that I started building last week, which is essentially like a wooden foldable tub, if you will, that I can now go ahead and fill up with a mixture of drywall compound and sand and start playing around with the material in the safety of my own flat, not having to worry about strong wind kicking in and potentially destroying what I've been working on the day earlier. Honestly speaking, this is so experimental that I have no clue if it's going to work out at all, however it looked too fun to not at least try it. So this wraps it up for this week. I hope you enjoyed this little video. Please let me know what you think, as video creation is something I'm really keen to get better at, but I already had tons of fun making it, so I hope you enjoyed it a little bit too. I wish you all the best on your own project, and have a good one. See you next week.